Yes, who is it? Come in. Sister Anna.
Sister Faith.
You are welcome.
Thank you very much. I was here 30 minutes ago, thinking you would have returned. Oh. You stayed a little late in church today.
Yes, the counseling team had to wait to attend to some converts after the church service. And there were quite a number of them.
Thank God for that. Where is everybody?
They are still in church. My husband has a committee meeting and the kids chose to stay back with him. I had to leave then to get dinner ready. You are here for the forms, I guess.
Sure. I have to submit it tomorrow morning. Sister Faith, your eyes look reddened. Did something enter your eyes?
No, nothing.
Sister Faith, is there anything the matter? Have you been crying? Talk to me. I've always known you to be an ever cheerful sister. What's the matter?
It was what happened in the church tonight.
What was that?
There was a guest minister in our church tonight. He has an extraordinary knowledge of the scriptures. He preached so powerfully. Over 200 people surrendered their lives to Christ after his ministration. It was wonderful.
Amen. Amen.
All right. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you, sir. Sir, your meal will be here in a short while.
Oh, please don't bother.
But sir, is it that you want to?
No, not tonight. Thank you.
Or you prefer something light? Say, some snacks, sir?
Not tonight. Gentlemen, thank you very much.
Good night,
good
sir.
Night, sir.
Thank you. Have a good night, too.
The man of God has a unique anointing for healing. For the first time in my life, I saw raw miracles taking place. I mean, raw miracles. Can you imagine an amputated arm growing back to normal right before your eyes?
Eh?
My sister, I was dazed. Towards the end of his ministration, a rare form of revelation gift took over. He called out and ministered to all manner of cases. He later said there was a sister in the congregation whose spiritual life had suffered a serious decline. He went on to give some specific details about the person's past and present life, including some very private details. My sister, I didn't know when I began to shake on my seat.
Why?
Because I knew he was talking about me. Because the description perfectly fits me. The only thing he didn't do was to mention my name. I went straight to the altar and prayed my heart out.
That was why you broke down in tears.
That was part of the reason. But what actually pierced my heart and brought tears to my eyes is the fact that the man of God in question is my convert.
Really?
I remember meeting him on a bus while traveling from Lagos to Benin 4 years ago. He sat next to me and I was moved by the Holy Spirit to start a discussion with him, during which he simply introduced himself as Mr. Gideon. I discovered he was an unbeliever, a chronic one for that matter. I ended up telling him of the love of God, demonstrated by the sacrificial death of Jesus on the cross of Calvary. The Holy Spirit convicted him such that he surrendered his life to Christ right there on the bus.
Oh, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Mm.
Hello, sir.
Hello, Evangelist. I thank God for your ministration tonight. It was great.
I give God the glory.
Yes. Our protocol officers just reported to me that you refused your dinner. I'm sorry. The fault is mine. I forgot to tell them that you are currently on a marathon fast.
I guessed as much. All the same, I thank you for the hospitality, sir.
You're welcome. They'll be there to pick you for the minister's conference by 9:30 tomorrow morning. I hope that's okay by you.
Very okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
He told me he was a Benin-based businessman. And since I was then based in Lagos, I collected his phone number through which I monitored his growth in the Lord and encouraged him to be steadfast. We eventually lost contact when I misplaced my former cell phone, along with some other important phone numbers. When I saw the name Evangelist Gideon Ossai, he didn't sound familiar at all. When he eventually arrived for the program and mounted the stage, I recognized the face, but I couldn't place exactly where we had met. It was when he briefly shared the testimony of his conversion that it finally struck me that he was the same Mr. Gideon that God used me to get converted. I'm sure he did not know I was in the church. When he began to demonstrate a high level of spiritual intensity, I was both happy and sorry at the same time.
How do you mean?
I was happy to see that my convert is still standing in the Lord. But I was sorry for myself that while a brother who got converted through me barely 4 years ago has grown to become a mighty weapon in the hand of the Lord, I, that got born again 21 years ago, have lost my spiritual steam. My Bible study life has deteriorated. My prayer life is zero. My evangelism life is gone. Even my zeal for the things of the Lord is at the lowest ebb. When he called my case and described me in that service, I was very sorry for myself. Oh my God.
That's all right, my sister. Don't brood over the sorry state of your spiritual life. Just thank God for loving you so much to call your attention to your spiritual state. By the way, were you able to meet with the evangelist after the service?
No. I wasn't in the mood to see anybody. I just wanted to be alone to pour out my heart to God.
This is a call to those of us who have known the Lord for some time, not to rest on our oars. We should not forget what Jesus said, but many that are first shall be last, and the last shall be first.
Oh my God!
I have all the information right here. I'm afraid our fear has been confirmed. The man is a real threat to our kingdom.
Really?
His name is Gideon Ossai. They call him Evangelist. He surrendered his life to that man 4 years ago. He caught fire right from day one and started wreaking havoc against our kingdom with reckless abandon. Within the last 4 years, he has converted 139 people to that man through personal evangelism. Another 217,431 people were won through the open air crusades he has held across the length and breadth of the country. As a matter of fact, He has preached at 64 of such crusades in the last 4 years. He has ministered healing to 56,405 sick people. He used the name of that righteous man to raise 6 dead people back to life.
This is an emergency.
I also have it on record that Gideon has been running a free discipleship class through which several thousands have been trained, and more have been trained to become fanatical followers of that man like himself.
This is indeed an emergency. Carry. Yo Davin. Evangelist, this is where we prepare for you to pass the night. We are very sorry. This is about the best that we can provide in the village.
It's okay. It's okay.
We will not want you to stay in any of our huts because of the hot weather. I hope you will bear with us.
Oh, with all pleasure, sir. This is very okay.
Thanks for your humility. I hope this will keep mosquitoes away. Thank you for your ministration in the church tonight. Just imagine, just one night is like many nights put together. How we wish that you spent a few more days with us.
I would have loved to, but you very well know.
We know that you have to go and minister somewhere else tomorrow. We the villagers, we know what you have done in our lives.
Ah, it's not me. It's God. To him be all the glory.
Amen. There's only one vehicle that leaves the village daily. It is actually a truck that carries our women to and fro the town to sell in the town market. It leaves around 5 a.m. I hope you'll be awake by then so as to follow it to the town from where you will catch another vehicle to your destination.
Oh, that's all right. No problem.
Thank you very much. I will be here to bid you farewell.
All right, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
We are very grateful.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Yes,
sir. Good night, sir. Oh, Father, thank you for the privilege to serve you in this village.
Father, I thank you for the privilege to serve you in this city. My God, I beg you, please don't allow success to get into my head. I pray for the grace to remain humble in the face of ministerial breakthroughs and achievements.
Gideon is currently planning what is believed to be the mother of all crusades, being for Kukumasi town. And this will be followed by another one at Mulegu.
Hey! Okukumasi! Mulegu! The two towns are our major strongholds. When you talk of hell-bound people, Okukumasi and Muleko, are them in abundance. No, we can't afford to lose those towns.
In fact, we dare not lose them. Otherwise, we will invoke the wrath of our Lord Lucifer. That is my greatest fear. And your honor, that our Lord Lucifer already doubts our ability to oversee this territory. We can't afford to allow that bastard named Gideon to put us in more trouble with our master.
This is an emergency. This is an emergency. What shall we do? Where do we go from here? Fellow agents, what do we do?
Let us strike him! Let us hit him! Let us get him off the scene!
That is quite brilliant! But we must not forget the words of the Master of the Universe. He said in their holy book that we should not touch his anointed and we should not do his prophet any harm.
Without any doubt, Gideon Ossai is an anointed servant of the Almighty. We dare not touch him.
This makes the task more difficult. The real problem is that we don't even know the secret of his spiritual prowess. All we know is that Gideon is very intimate with his God. I have an idea. Then share it. Let us probe into his life and find out the secret of his outstanding testimony and exceptional exploits. From there, we can strategize and strike.
Words are inadequate to express my gratitude to all of us for our strong commitment towards the preparation for this crusade.
Brethren, this is from the market woman.
Market woman?
You mean our women contributed this much?
This is great.
While the financial secretary is busy with that, I think we can go ahead with our discussions.
Yes.
Yes, Pastor Benle.
Yes, sir.
How far has your community gone with mobilization for the crusade?
We thank God, sir. Things are gradually taking shape. The banners are now ready.
To God be the glory.
We have 30 of them here. The artists came in from Usogo late last night to deliver them.
Pastor Lou, come on.
Okay. This is good.
This is wonderful.
Yes.
We also have a handwritten posters.
This is wonderful. It comes out beautiful. Yes.
By God's grace, The posters and the flyers will be ready very soon.
Hallelujah.
Meanwhile, I'm happy to report that the Lord has helped us to record a major breakthrough. The chairman of the Christian community in Akudera sent us a message that their king, Alakude of Akudera, has finally agreed to allow as many as are interested from their town to come down to Mulegun to participate in it.
Oh! Holy!
Worship God.
Brethren, this is a great news.
Yes.
The impossible is becoming possible right before our eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh! We trust God to use this crusade to finally end the Cold War and break the shackle of envy and bitterness which have existed between the people of Akudeola and Mulegun for so many years.
Amen.
Please have your seat.
Thank you, sir.
Please sit down.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Now, lady and gentlemen, as I said earlier, this interview would not have been possible without the consent and express permission of the evangelist. Please don't forget, you have just a few minutes to spend with him. He needs to catch some rest before the evening rally. You know he's been speaking at the minister's conference for close to 2 hours now.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
While you attend to them, would you permit me some time to do a few things in the church?
Oh, no problem, sir. That's all right.
Yes, my brother and sister.
Thank you, sir. Now, we are journalists from the Explorer newspapers. My name is Sam Olatilewa, and my colleague here is Ngozi Okafo.
You're welcome.
Thank you, sir. We have been on your trail for quite some time now. Well, we heard that you will be in town to preach at this program. Our editor-in-chief directed us to get across to you and ensure that we return back with an exclusive interview. We saw it as an uphill task since we didn't have a prayer appointment with you. We just decided to try our luck, and here we are. So we consider it a real privilege to sit here and talk with you, sir.
To God be the glory.
Sir, the name Evangelist Gideon Ossai is a household name. Can we meet you, sir?
Well, I will first like to correct the wrong notion that my name is a household name. No, the real household name is Jesus. Without him, I'm nothing. I'm what I am by his grace. Now to your question. I'm Gideon Ossai. I hail from southeastern part of Nigeria. I had my primary and secondary school education in Benin City. I lost my father when I was in Form 2. I couldn't proceed to the university because my mother couldn't afford to train me any further. She was a petty trader who merely struggled to see me through my secondary school education.
Ah, it is now very obvious that the grammar school field would not be able to accommodate the expected crowd.
That's true.
I mean, with people coming from about 9 neighboring towns and villages, wisdom demands that we look for a bigger venue for the crusade.
That's true. But I'm afraid it's already too late to change the venue, since Mulegun Grammar School Playground has already been indicated on the banners.
It is also on posters and flyers which are presently in the press.
We have a good problem in our hands. How do we help the situation?
Sir, during the last visit of the logistics subcommittee to the school field, we noticed that there is a wide expanse of land right beside the school field. It should be about 3 times the size of the school field.
Oh, really?
Yes, sir.
That settles it.
Mm.
Sir, the only problem is that the land is already overgrown with some tall grasses and big trees. We need to clear it.
That should not be a problem. We can hire graders or bulldozers to clear the land.
Okay, that's true.
Right. Where can we hire the necessary equipment? And how much would they cost?
I later opted for trading. I served as an apprentice under Obi and brothers for 5 years, after which I had my own outfit. Things didn't go the way I expected. The business wasn't booming. One of my friends introduced me to a cult where I entered into a covenant and carried out some rituals for business breakthrough. Well, my brother, the breakthrough actually came, but as you very well know, Satan does not have a free gift. He gives you one in exchange for another. I lost 2 of my children to the cult. My search for greater power pushed me deeper and deeper into cultism. At the last count, I belonged to 19 different cults, including the dreaded Obubuikosi cult.
Hmm. How did you become a Christian?
I was coming to that. It happened 4 years ago. God, in His infinite mercy, arranged it such that I sat beside a Christian lady on a night bus from Lagos to Benin. She simply introduced herself to be Sister Faith.
We thank God for it that He has helped us, and we know that He will help us further. Yeah. Yes. This is a miracle. You mean our people contributed this much?
I didn't believe it myself. I had to calculate the total sum 3 times to really confirm what I was seeing.
This is already more than what we budgeted for the entire crusade.
The interesting thing is that some of the churches who had made their full contributions promised to raise and send in more.
Sir, I think this is an indication that God actually has a hand in the forthcoming crusade.
Indeed, it is. In addition to that, our people really believe in the ministry of evangelist Gideon Ossai. You need to hear how well they speak of him. Many believe that he's coming to Mulegun will bring divine blessings and healings to our town.
We should thank God for everything.
God be the glory.
Brethren, the enthusiasm being shown by people should challenge us to intensify our prayers for the crusade. Because the devil will not fold his arms and watch his stronghold being destroyed in our land.
Yes. Now, to the program that brought you to town. You are supposed to be here for 3 nights. But after only 1 night, the news of the great miracles which you lost last night has spread like wide Amatan fire.
Point of correction. I did not rot any miracle. God did. He only used me as a vessel.
Thank you, sir. The minister's conference that was held this morning equally attracted a huge crowd. The evening rally for tonight is still a couple of hours away, but the entire auditorium has already been filled up. The overflow within the church compound is also filling up. Yet, more and more people are trooping in. Sir, will it be correct to say the miracles of the first night are responsible for this?
Well, partly yes, because that was the trend during the earthly ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ. Multitudes thronged after him because of the miracles he performed. And above all, I believe it's the Holy Spirit that is bringing the people.
Sir, what is your secret in ministry?
God's grace.
What else?
Nothing else.
Well, you are preparing to storm Okukumasi for a gospel crusade. And we heard he's going to be the mother of all crusades.
Sorry, I'm not storming Okukumasi. God is the one visiting the land. Besides, I didn't call it the mother of all crusade. It's you media people that gave it that name.
Yes, sir. What should we expect from the crusades?
The glory of God. God will be highly lifted up and multitude will be drawn to his kingdom.
You are also built to be in Mulegun, that is southwest Nigeria, for another crusade, just 5 days after the Okukumasi crusade, which will take place in the east. Sir, how do you cope with your many travels and your numerous preaching engagements?
And sir, how do you combine your ministry work with the demands of your immediate family?
God's grace. God has been and is still the source of my strength. I must add, however, that wisdom is profitable to direct. For this reason, I try to plan my programs in such a way that after a series of programs, I try to stay back at home, rest, and refuel. More so, I try not to be away from my family for a long time in a stretch. You know, my family is my first and the most important ministry. If I fail in my family, I will never succeed in ministry.
Thank you for that revelation, sir.
Many fake ministers have infiltrated the Christian ministries. Sir, what do you have to say about this?
Well, I'm afraid I can't comment on that. God called me into ministry to come and contribute my own quarter to the advancement of the kingdom. I was not called to come and assess or criticize anybody.
Thank you, sir. Now, looking at the rate at which our youths are going these days, I think we have to stop here.
Well, I'm afraid, yes. The evangelist needs to catch some rest. I'm indeed very sorry. I hope you understand.
Oh, very well, sir. Yes. Thanks for the favor, sir.
And thanks for your time, sir.
Oh, you're welcome.
Yes, can you pray for us before we take our leave, sir?
Oh, why not? Father, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The territorial agents commissioned by the prince of the world to oversee region 9 division 4 segment 727 of Africa. Our main duty is to protect the interest of our Lord Lucifer in the division under our care. For your information, Nigeria, where you live and operate, is under our jurisdiction.
And since your so-called conversion to that man, you have been destabilizing our region. So we are here to advise you to pack your load and leave.
Otherwise, stop terrorizing us. The choice is yours.
That's impossible.
What do you mean, impossible?
How dare you tell us it's impossible?
I have a mandate to fulfill and there's no stopping me.
Mandate? Who gave you the mandate?
My senior partner, of course.
Who is that?
Oh, if you really care to know him, I will introduce him to you. Sweet Holy Spirit, my senior partner.
Welcome, Holy Spirit, my senior partner. should have known better.
Sweet Holy Spirit, thank you for being there for me.
You're welcome.
I only urge you to always remember that it has been written of me, when I, the Spirit of Truth, is come, I will guide you into all truth. For I will not speak of my own self. Whatsoever I shall hear, that will I speak, and I will show you things to come. Your adversary, the devil, is out to steal, to kill, and to destroy. Beloved, I charge you to guard your loins. Trust in the Lord. Be fruitful. Remain steadfast. Abide in the vineyard. Above all, abstain from all unrighteousness, and it shall be well with you.
Thank you, sweet Holy Spirit.
That was what I saw in the dream.
This is incredible.
Why did you say that?
That was exactly what I saw in my dream last night. I now believe that it was not an ordinary dream. It must be a revelation.
Yes, a divine revelation. Man of God, please permit me to preach to you.
Sir, you don't need to beg me for permission. Please, free. Go ahead. Tell me whatever the Lord has for me through you.
Thank you. Let him that thinks he stands take heed lest he falls. So says the Holy Scriptures. It is rather unfortunate that much as ministers of God, care for and honestly admonish the flock of Christ under our care to take heed and avoid falling, we often get careless about our own lives and end up falling prey to the wiles and devices of the devil. I pray this will not be your portion.
Amen.
Please, don't frustrate the grace of God upon your life. As the Lord lives, the force of darkness will not prevail over you.
Amen.
The Lord who called you will not allow you to fall.
Amen.
Thank God I'm early enough today. He should be out in a few minutes.
Sister Faith, did you eventually get to meet the evangelist?
Evangelist Gideon? Sure, I did. Didn't I tell you?
No.
But I'm sure I spoke with somebody. Oh, my sister-in-law was the one I spoke with. I'm very sorry.
That's all right. I'm just curious.
I sought my pastor's permission to meet the evangelist. He arranged for a meeting in his office. I was there with my husband. So the evangelist couldn't recognize me initially. But when I recounted how I met and ministered salvation to him several years ago, he was really, really excited. I told him about my spiritual problem. He counseled and he prayed for me. Oh, look at my little angels.
Demirane,
how are you?
You are welcome.
Yes, your auntie, did you finish your food?
I just.
How are you? Demirane? Hola, how are you? How are you today?
Did you actually finish your food?
Yes.
Everything?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm sure we'll be happy when we get home.
In Jesus' name, I pray.
Amen. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank God. My beloved evangelist, I wish to convey the profound gratitude of our church assembly to you. I must confess, the impact of your ministrations in the last 3 days
cannot be quantified.
It's not me. It's God. To him be all the glory.
Without any doubt, the cordial relationship between Gideon and the Holy Spirit makes it extremely difficult for us to strike him. We must find a way to destroy that relationship.
I agree with you. I remember their constitution says, grieve not the Holy Spirit. I think the easiest way for us to destroy their relationship is to make Gideon grieve that Holy Spirit. And their constitution also says that he that committed sins is us. Meaning, when we make Gideon fall into sin, he automatically becomes us. And that will terminate his service in that man's kingdom.
What a brilliant idea! Now, what kind of iniquity do we introduce into his life?
Let us lure him with the love of money. I believe we can map out a strategy, a plan that will get him distracted because of money and eventually lose focus.
Wow! We got it! We got it! Gideon's days are numbered.
Yes, they are numbered. And few are his days.
Waiting for time, the devil is waiting. Do not let him get you.
Yes, please come in.
Waiting for time to strike us children. Do
good morning, sir. Please, have your seat.
Thank you very much, sir. I am from Senator Nicholas Chukwu Okorowanta.
Oh, yeah. He gave me a phone call yesterday and told me to be sending someone to me. You're most welcome.
Oh, thanks a lot, sir. Actually, I am his personal assistant. Sir, the distinguished senator asked me to give this to you. He's marking his 50th birthday anniversary and he wants you to speak at the occasion.
Sixteenth and 17th of next month?
Yes, sir. The first day will be in Abuja, while the second will be at a special Thanksgiving service in the senator's hometown.
That will be a week after Okukumasi Crusade.
Yes, we are aware of that, sir. But we believe that shouldn't be a problem.
Not really. The problem is that I've been built to hold a 3-day special crusade at Mulegun town, running from 16th to 18th. And I can't afford to miss it. I have to be there.
Ah. Sir, the senator will be utterly disappointed if you don't make it to his birthday ceremony. You see, he carefully selected you out of the multitude of preachers in this country. He believes you have what it takes to minister to the political juggernauts that will be in attendance. And for your information, sir, other distinguished senators will be in attendance, including the Senate president himself. Not to mention several federal ministers, political moguls, business magnates that will also come to grace the occasion. In fact, sir, we expect that men that really matter will be in attendance. Sir,
You cannot afford not to be there, sir. You can't.
Well, I quite understand you. But the truth is that I can't forgo the Malago Crusade for anything. I can't.
Sir, why don't you think of the immeasurable benefit your ministry stands to derive by you honoring the invitation? The occasion will provide a unique opportunity for you to meet the High and the Mighty, men and women of timber and caliber. I mean, the movers and the shakers of the society. Sir, you can be sure that a door of inestimable connection will blow open for you. I know, sir. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. You can't afford not to come. I almost forgot, sir. The distinguished senator also asked me to give this to you.
What is this?
20% advance honorarium.
For what?
For honoring our invitation.
I have not even accepted the invitation.
We know you will. We know you will come. We know that you cannot reject a call to minister to the ruling class and save the lost among them. Lest I forget, sir. An additional 40% will be paid on your arrival. And the final 40% will be paid as soon as you finish your ministration.
16th and 17th of next month.
Sir, no, you can't afford not to be there. You can't.
Holy Spirit, help me.
Gideon, the invitation is not the will of God. It is a snare of the devil. Beware of the love of money. Beware of the love of money.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. I'm sorry, sir. I can't honor the invitation.
You can't honor the invitation?
Or better put, I won't honor the invitation. Oh, that's all right. Let the man here immediately. I'm through with the restore with me. Sir, I hope I've made myself clear. I won't honor the invitation.
Look, sir, it seems you don't understand what I'm saying.
Of course I do. Please convey my heartfelt apologies to the senator. In any case, I will explain things to him later on phone. Thank you, sir.
But, man of God, I think you...
Sorry, please, I have another visitor. Please let the man in. Sir, your check.
He refused to fall. Commissioned agent 727 Africa. Our Lord Lucifer, we hail you. The three of you are a terrible disappointment. I assigned you to oversee Region 9, Division 4, Segment 727 of Africa. But you failed in the assignment. You allowed a bastard named Gideon Ossai to have dominion in the region. You allowed him to devastate my kingdom with reckless abandon. Now, tell me, what did you do to destroy his relationship with the Holy Spirit.
We tried to introduce the love of money into his life, but he refused to swallow the bait.
He refused to swallow the bait. How would he? I asked, how would he? By the way, have you decoded the secrets of his spiritual stronghold?
Spiritual stronghold?
You see, they don't even know what a spiritual stronghold is. I mean the things that keep him going spiritually. If you don't destroy these spiritual building blocks in the life of a Christian, you can never succeed in destroying such a Christian. Anyway, I have gathered important information on the secret of Gideon Ossai spiritual stronghold. Now, look. Read out the information. Yes, you.
Topic: Secret of Spiritual Stronghold. Subject: Gideon Ossai. Biological age: 44 years. Spiritual age: 4 years. Prayer life: prays at least 4 hours daily with personal prayer vigils once every week. Fasting life: fasts at least 3 days weekly with 7-day marathon fasting every 3 months. Bible study life: studies at least 15 chapters of the Bible daily. In addition, reads at least 5 Christian books every month. Giving life: pays his tithes faithfully and gives generously. Personal evangelism: wins an average of 5 souls every week. Spirituality: 92%. Still growing.
I'm sure you can answer why Gideon Ossai is a hard bone for you to crack.
Yes, master.
Remember, not until you destroy his spiritual stronghold, he will remain a formidable force against our kingdom. Not until you destroy his spiritual life, he will remain untouchable for us. With this important secret in your hand, I see no reason why Gideon Ossai will not fall like a pack of cats. So, now, devise a strategy and make him fall. No failure. I repeat, no failure.
What shall we do? Can we try the weapon of adultery?
Adultery? That would be too cheap.
Gideon is too big for that. He has gone too far with that righteous one. He can never fall into adultery. You see, my fellow agents, let's look for a more subtle sin to get him.
What do you mean, never?
Never say never. No Christian is too big for any sin. We have seen bishops fall flat for adultery in the past.
I agree with that. Moreover, there is no harm in trying.
In that case,
how do we get a woman that will carry out the assignment for us?
That should not be a problem. With so many daughters of Jezebel around in the world, we won't have to search far to get one of them to serve as a snare for him to fall into adultery. Let's give it a trial.
Yes, sister, what would God have me do for you?
Sir, I need your help.
God is our help. What's the problem?
Thank you, sir. Sir, I have suffered in life. Oh, I have suffered. I've been battered on every side. My life is an emotional wreck. I know God is the only one who can help me.
Sister, it's okay. That's all right, that's all right. Calm down, sister. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay. Sister, what exactly do you want?
I need your help. Please help me, sir.
You need help?
Yes, sir.
In that case, I will pray with you. The scripture says, the word of God is quick and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword. Father, I ask, let the secrets of the devil be revealed in this matter in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I command every unfruitful work of darkness to come under divine judgment in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, let fire fall from heaven and consume every token of the devil in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I stand under the rock of ages and I decree and declare that the name of Jesus,
sir,
every evil implantation.
Sir?
Yes.
Thank you, sir. I'm all right, sir.
What do you mean?
I mean, I'm all right, sir.
Sister? Sister!
Ah! No! Ah!
How soon did they promise to fix the problem?
They confessed to me that it may take a long while because they will have to travel to Lagos to get the faulty part. Even then, they can't guarantee if it will be readily available there.
This is unthinkable. The crusade will start in 5 days' time.
But we've paid for the use of the equipment. They should have serviced this
to avoid this kind of disappointment.
By the way, are you sure these people are not up to some mischief?
No. I don't think so. The manager told me the grader was serviced a month ago. And he was really sorry. He even promised to refund our money by tomorrow morning.
Brethren, we have to think of a way out of this unforeseen emergency. I suggest we get some men to cut the grasses and fell the trees.
But with what?
Machetes, cutlasses, hoes, axes, whatever they can lay their hands on.
This jungle, with just 5 days to go, how many men will be able to do the job?
If there is a way, there will always be a way. Let's mobilize all the able-bodied men in Mulegun to face the job. I believe with God on our side, this mountain, I mean this jungle, shall be made plain. Mulegun Gospel Crusade is a reality. Nothing will stop it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Welcome, Dad.
Oh, Mary,
How are you, my dear?
I'm fine.
Where are your younger ones?
They went for a picnic in church.
Alright.
Sister Favour was here to pick them. I spoke to you about it.
You did?
On phone.
Oh, yeah. You know, I have a lot of things on my head. Yeah. John also went with them?
He refused to stay behind.
I had to release him when he started crying.
John, the beloved.
Sister Favour promised to take a good care of him.
Okay.
They should be back by 6 p.m. And how was your journey back?
Hectic. But I thank God for his divine protection.
I also thank God for the wonderful testimonies you shared with me on phone.
God really glorified himself. Okukumasi is now for Jesus.
Thank God.
Chairman, sir, this is incredible. Who will believe that just within 2 days, a thick jungle will become an open field like this?
Indeed. If there is a will, there will always be a way.
We should just thank God for our people. They release themselves to be used of God. I'm also proud of every member of the Central Planning Committee. No one felt too big to hold a machete and join in clearing the bush. Only God will reward us appropriately.
Amen. Amen.
With God on our side, Mule Gun Gospel Crusade is now a reality.
Amen.
News reached me from Kukumasi that God used Evangelist Gideon Ossai mightily in the land. 3 days late for the commencement of Mule Gun Gospel Crusade seemed like 3 years to me. I can't wait to see God bring Evangelist Gideon Ossai to Mule Gun to demolish the kingdom of Satan. Well, I intend to personally visit the evangelist tomorrow to update him on our preparations so far.
That is very nice.
Thank God is with me.
You opened your eyes and allowed the Okuku Mercy Crusade to hold. Our captives were set free at the crusade. Meanwhile, preparations have reached an advanced stage for Mule Gun Gospel Crusade. And the signals I'm receiving show that the harvest from Mule Gun is going to be greater than that of Okukumasi. Are you aware of this?
Yes, master.
So, what steps have you taken to make sure the crusade does not hold? Answer me!
My Lord Lucifer, we have a confession to make.
What confession?
We have used almost all of the most potent weapons of iniquity in our armory to attack Gideon. But he refused to fall.
Yes, master. We have used the love of money, women, hunger, bitterness, hypocrisy, and
we even manufactured rumors and spread such about him to distract and destroy his ministry. As a matter of fact, we used a fellow minister of his to start and spread the last rumor about him. But he never wasted any time to refute rumors and allegations. The more we tried, the stronger he became. Our Lord Lucifer, Gideon Ossai, is an impossible case for us.
I hope you are not planning to back out of the assignment. Of course you can't.
In our kingdom, there is nothing like giving up. So, go back there and destroy Gideon Ossai. By the way, have you tried the weapon of pride?
No, master. No.
Pride. Pride. Pride is a subtle but potent weapon of destruction. Remember that the Almighty stripped me of my position and cast us out of heaven because of pride. The standard has not yet changed. Pride is still a destroyer. Their constitution says pride goes before destruction and a haughty spirit before a fall. Make Gideon have a feeling of self-importance. Fill him with the spirits of arrogance. Clothe him with the garment of pride. And as soon as pride enters into him, the Holy Spirit will leave him. As soon as the Holy Spirit leaves, his prayer life, Bible study lives, and others will deteriorate. And as soon as this happens, strike him! But there is an important precaution. Remember, their constitution says in Proverbs chapter 11, verse 14, where there is no cancer, the people fall. But in the multitude of counselors, there is safety. If you want to succeed in this assignment, keep Gideon away from friends, elders, family members, and even fellow ministers who can give him good counsel. I mean, those who can stand up, face him, and tell him the truth.
How do we do this?
You can make him be quarrels with them without any tangible reason. Just make sure you isolate him completely from people who can help him spiritually.
My Lord Lucifer, we thank you for giving us a lifeline. But I want to ask, how fast will this strategy work?
You don't have any business with how fast it works. Your duty is to wait patiently until it works. You know, in our kingdom, we cherish the virtues of endurance, patience, and perseverance. So, no matter how long it takes, we are ready to suffer long and wait until we see to the downfall of any Christian we target. Gideon Ossai's case, it's only a matter of time. Remain at your duty post and wait patiently for time. I repeat, wait for time.
God bless you, my sister. I'm happy to see you again.
Thank you, sir. My husband sent his greetings.
Is he?
He's very fine.
Thank God. Yes.
I wish to start by first thanking you for the spiritual assistance you offered to me the last time you came to minister in our church.
Ah, that's all right. How is your spiritual life now?
I must confess, your counsel and prayers really revived my spirit and got me back on my feet. I thank God for your life, sir.
I should be the one to thank you again and again. I believe I can't possibly repay you for being the medium through whom God saved my life.
To him be the glory.
Yes, Sister Faith. Sister gave me a phone call 2 days ago. I've been wondering what it is you want to tell me that we can't discuss on phone.
Yes, sir. I have a message for you from the Lord. And I felt it would be discourteous for me to deliver the message on the phone. That's why I chose to travel down here. To see you. Can I go on, sir?
Oh, yes. I'm all ears.
God showed me a vision a few days ago. And in the vision, I saw a huge crowd of people gathered together in a place that looked like a village square. In the center of the circle, I saw some demons seated and making music with different types of local musical instruments. I noticed that as melodious as their music was, nobody danced to it. They begged and encouraged the onlookers who stood nearby to dance, but nobody responded. Eventually, a man stepped forward and started moving towards the demons. Some of his fellow onlookers persuaded him not to go. Some even pulled him back. But he eventually broke loose, ran to where the demons were, and started dancing to their music. As they increased the tempo of their drumming, the man danced more vigorously, while the demons clapped and cheered him on. All of a sudden, the man collapsed and died. The next thing I saw was that the onlookers shook their heads as they left one after the other. In the end, the demons carried the man's dead body and left with it.
Yes, go on.
That's all.
And how do I come into the picture?
Sir, the man I saw in the vision was you.
Me?
The Holy Spirit told me to warn you to beware of pride. He said the host of darkness has perfected plans to use the weapon of pride to destroy your ministry. They are currently beating the drums of pride. The Holy Spirit said you should not dance to it.
Well, thanks for your vision. But I'm sorry to say that the vision was not from God. It was a product of your imagination. When I listen to a vision from God, I know it without any mistake. Besides, God is a God of order and decorum. He will never use a vessel of a lower anointing to convey a message to the one of a higher anointing. In case you don't know, there are levels in the things of the Spirit. By the way, I gave you this privilege to speak to me because of the regard I have for you. I beg you, don't misuse the privilege to disrespect the anointing of God upon my life.
No, sir.
I've made my point. Thanks. Good day.
Waiting for time, the devil is waiting. Do not let him get you. Waiting for time to strike us children. Do not let him get you.
The senator will be utterly disappointed if you don't make it to his birthday ceremony.
I can't forgo the Mulegun crusade.
Of course, you can. In fact, you have to. You have operated long enough as a village and town evangelist. You seem not to know your real worth. The anointing upon your life is too big for local operations. It's time to move to the next level. It's time to break into national and international limelight.
Sir, why don't you think of the immeasurable benefit your ministry stands to derive by you honoring the invitation?
The senator's birthday will offer you a unique springboard to launch into the next level. You may never have an opportunity like this again. Wisdom is profitable to direct.
Don't, don't let him. Satan is watching, waiting for the time. Don't let him. Satan is watching, waiting for the time. Satan has come to steal, he has come to kill and to destroy. He's waiting for the time to bring you down. You better watch your ways.
Hello, good afternoon. Please, is that Senator Nicholas Okoronwanta?
What should I tell my people back home?
Exactly what I told you.
That the crusade had been cancelled?
Hey, Pastor, please don't put words in my mouth. I didn't say the crusade had been cancelled. I only said I will no longer be available to preach at the crusade. That I should get someone else.
We are saying the same thing. You said you can no longer come for the crusade. After we have mobilized the whole of Mulegun and over 20 neighboring villages to attend the crusade. We have even sourced for money within the Christian community to book for trucks and buses, to convey people daily from the neighboring villages to Mulegun for the crusade and back after us. We have even cleared a wide expanse of forest to be used as a venue for the crusade.
Look, Pastor, you seem not to understand me.
Of course I do. You want to back out? And it was only last week that our king, Amulegun of Mulegun, finally agreed to be personally present on the crusade ground along with his chiefs. We even give thanks to God, believing that Jesus will arrest our king at the crusade and deliver the town from idolatry. Unfortunately, our dream is going down the drain.
Pastor Tulubalashe, you seem not to understand me. I didn't just decide not to come. You see, I have a higher calling to minister somewhere else.
Higher calling?
Yes. I have to be in Abuja to minister at the birthday anniversary of Senator Nicholas Okoronwanta. We even spoke on phone yesterday. You see, Holy Spirit specifically ordered me to be there. Incidentally, his program falls on the same period with your crusade.
Point of correction. It is not my crusade. It was originally your vision. Remember, you were the one who personally came to Mulegun to hold a meeting with all Christian leaders. You told us that God led you to come and hold a crusade in our town. That was about 6 months ago. We gladly accepted and set the ball rolling for the crusade. We set up various subcommittees. The choir has been rehearsing twice every week for 2 months. The prayer team has been lifting up the crusade in prayers for close to 4 months now. In fact, they are rounding off a 40-day fasting and prayer program tomorrow. By the way, my dear evangelist, when did you get to know about this Abuja program?
That is immaterial for now. I think what is important here now is to get someone else to preach at a crusade. If you wouldn't mind, I'll get you another preacher. On the alternative, if you people can wait, I'll look out for time and to come down to your town. Which one do you choose?
None of the above. Thank you.
Pastor, where are you going?
Back to Mulego. To break the unfortunate news of the brethren. My people will be shattered. Well, we will call for a time of serious prayers where we will report the developments to God and seek His face on the next course of action.
Well, Pastor, I sent my sincere apology and convey the same to your people back home.
You don't need to apologize to us. I advise you to apologize to God. Evangelist Gideon Ossai, the God we serve is not an utter of confusion. He cannot send you to Mulegu town and ask you to be in Abuja city at the same time. He cannot ask you to spend months preparing for a crusade and ask you to call it off 2 days to the D-Day. Remember, God is not mocked.
Honey, you canceled Mulegu crusade?
Oh, so you'll be eavesdropping?
Why? And when?
God asked me to go to Abuja instead. And for your information, I did not cancel the crusade. I only asked them to get someone else.
But you never discussed this with me.
I chose not to.
Why not? This is much unlike you.
You won't... I mean... You can't understand.
This is strange.
We are winning!
Yes.
We are winning!
We are winning!
We are winning! Gideon has fallen into the snare of pride!
We are winning!
We are winning!
We are winning!
Exactly! I think what we are going to do now is to wait patiently for the time when his spirituality will fall further. Then we'll finish him up!
Exactly! We can wait!
We will wait!
We are waiting for that!
Still on the program, Kingdom Waves, reaching you live from Dominion FM from the city of Abuja. I have in the studio with me a renowned man of God, Evangelist Gideon Ossai. He's in Abuja to promote the Kingdom of God. Sir, it's so nice to have you on the program.
It's my pleasure.
Sir, I wish to start by congratulating you for the success of the recently held Okukumasi Crusade.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. Can you please give a general overview of the crusade?
Well, the crusade will go into record as the biggest gospel crusade organized by an indigenous evangelist in the history of this country. an estimated population of over 500,000 attended the crusade each night. It was beamed live on two different satellite TV channels. A radio station was also on ground to broadcast live happenings on the crusade ground to unknown millions across the country and beyond. Mind you, it was also live on the internet.
How did you achieve this mind-boggling feat?
Well, it took serious planning, hard work and commitment. We put in every effort to make it happen, and it happened. In short, it was not a child's play.
There were many miracles at the crusade and...
Yes, very many, too many to count. I hope you heard that a dead woman was brought back to life.
Yes, it was also reported that a renowned madman regained his senses.
Sure. That one was a very simple miracle. It just took a word of authority from my mouth.
Sir, the power to work miracles is lacking in the lives of so many ministers of God today. Meanwhile, miracles have become commonplace in your home ministry. So what's your secret?
Well, I pay the price.
And what exactly is that, sir?
Yes, my relationship with the Holy Spirit is very cordial. And that gives me free access to God every time. You see, I devour many chapters of the Bible daily. My prayer life is beyond the ordinary. For your information, I engage my prayer team on a 21-day prayer chain in preparation for Kukumasi Crusade. Tell me, why would miracles take place? It must take place. Look, let's put that one aside. I don't want people out there to say I'm proud.
Oh, sir, where do you see yourself in the next 5 years?
Well, I can see Gideon Ossai becoming the greatest evangelist of our generation. I want to become the reference point for world evangelization. At this stage, I want to start reaping the fruits of my spiritual investment over the years. I pay my dues. Yes, I don't need too many prayer and fasting to get things done again. The anointing on me is enough to break every yoke of the devil.
Finally, sir, why exactly are you in Abuja?
Yes, a highly placed political figure in this country is celebrating his 50th birthday anniversary and especially invited me to come and speak at a church service tomorrow morning and at the grand reception in the evening. I will also be on the celebration train to his hometown the day after tomorrow, where I'll be speaking at a Thanksgiving reception organized by his kinsmen.
Thank you very much, sir.
It's my pleasure.
You must be a fool to ask me that question.
How dare you talk to me like that? Don't you know who I am?
You? Who are you?
My God!
My Lord Lucifer. Yes. Who are you?
I'm a son of the living God, a servant of the Most High, a battle axe of the Almighty, an ambassador of the kingdom. I'm called, ordained, and anointed to devastate your kingdom.
Very good introduction. But you forgot to add that you are also an ambassador of my kingdom.
Which kingdom?
My kingdom, Lucifer's kingdom, of course. It is written in your constitution that he that committed sin is of the devil. Yes. You are mine because you are a sinner.
You must be out of your mind to come in here and tell me I'm a sinner. Now, get out. I said, get out.
Hey, save your breath. Your barking like a dog does not move me an inch. You can as well eat your head against the wall.
No, Lucifer. I can't take any more of your insult. You eternally hopeless, God-forsaken fallen angel, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus.
Good attempt. You have just used the powerful name of the righteous one to rebuke me. I respect that name. It is the name above all names. But for your information, the name is powerful. Only, I repeat, only in the mouth of those who walk according to the will of the owner of the name. But in your mouth, the name does not make any meaning.
What are you talking about?
Your constitution says in Proverbs chapter 28 verse 9 that he that turns away his ear from hearing the law, even his prayer shall be an abomination. Your prayer is an abomination in the ear of the Almighty. He cannot hearken to the voice of a sinner like you.
No, Lucifer, you cannot intimidate me. Because you are a liar and father of all lies. Hippokia Yesanda Marisa Hula Marasan.
Hey! What was that supposed to be? Speaking in tongues? You? Speaking in tongues? Of course. You didn't speak in tongues. You only spoke rubbish. You fired blank bullets. It's because you are nothing but an empty vessel making a loud noise.
No. 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 No.
Relax, Mr. Evangelist. It is not by might, nor by power.
But by the Spirit, says the Lord. Yes. Yes, it is written, when the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will raise up a standard against him. Hold it. I know what to do. Holy Spirit of the living God, please come and deliver me from the enemies of righteousness. Holy Spirit, please come. Oh, sweet Holy Spirit, you welcome. The enemies of righteousness are be raging against me. Please fight for me. Please.
My hands are tied.
Why?
It is written, grieve not the Holy Spirit of God. Gideon, you have grieved me. It is also written, quench not the Spirit. Gideon, you have quenched me.
Oh, Holy Spirit, I'm confused.
It is written, the hand of the Lord is not shortened that he cannot save. Neither is ear heavy that he will not hear. But your iniquity have separated between you and your God. And your sins have hid his face from you so that he will not hear. For your hands are defiled with blood. Your fingers with iniquity. Your lips have spoken lies. and your tongue has muttered perverseness. I cannot behold iniquity, Gideon. I cannot condone unrighteousness. Your sin-infested life is no longer fit for me to live in. I must take my leave. Now.
Holy Spirit, please, don't go. If you leave me, I will be doomed. If you leave me, my life will be meaningless. If you leave me, I will be at the mercy of the devil. Holy Spirit, please, please. Holy Spirit, please don't leave me. Pardon me. Please don't go. Help me, Holy Spirit. I'm sorry, please, Holy Spirit. Have mercy on me, Holy Spirit. It is written, if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sin, you are faithful and just to forgive us from all unrighteousness. Holy Spirit, I know I'm a sinner. I've grieved you. Yes, I know. Please, forgive me. Have mercy on me. Mercy. Mercy.
Hold it. Let him go. The Lord is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Gideon, since you have repented of your sins, you are hereby forgiven. I have an obligation to return to you. Behold, your adversary, the devil, goes about as a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. He is always waiting for time to strike every faithful child of God. I charge you, give no room to the devil again.
My dear evangelist, I'm very sorry to bother you this early.
Yes, sir.
I know you must have slept late last night, being the first night of the Mulegun crusade. How was it? Hello? Hello? Evangelist?
Yes, sir.
I asked, how was the first night of the crusade? Are you still there?
Yes, sir.
I guess there's a problem with the service network. In any case, if you can still hear me, the Lord spoke to me during my morning devotion, which ended a few minutes ago. He asked me to tell you that the devil has set a trap to ensnare you and is only waiting patiently for the time you will walk into it for him to finish you off. I just called to warn you and to assure you that I'm praying for you.
Sir, the devil did not have to wait for too long. I have already walked into his trap.
What's going on? Evangelist! Are you weeping? Evangelist!
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry. I don't understand what you just said. Where exactly are you?
I'm in Abuja.
Abuja? What are you doing there?
I was deceived.
Hello? Hello?
Waiting for time, the devil is waiting. Do not let him get you. Waiting for time to strike God's children. Do not let him get you.
Hello, Evangelist. Good morning.
Good morning, sir. I believe the crusade started yesterday.
Yes, it did.
Ah, praise God. I just called to notify you that I'll be leaving Abuja this morning. And I catch the first flight to Lagos, and from Lagos I charter a cab to Mulegun. I'll be with you before evening.
What are you coming for?
I'm coming to continue with you. I mean, to minister as originally planned.
That won't be necessary.
Why?
When you opted out of the crusade, we went into serious prayers and sought God's face on the next course of action.
God told us that
for every fearful Elijah, there are at least 7,000 other ministers waiting on the flanks to take his place.
God specifically led us to
Oshogo to invite another man of God. It will interest you to know that the man in question is a 14-year-old boy.
He arrived
in Mulegun yesterday afternoon and ministered powerfully
at the opening rally in the evening.
Several thousands of souls were won for Jesus. God used him to perform mighty miracles. The whole of Mulegun and other neighboring villages are on fire for Jesus.
As a matter of fact,
people have started trooping to the venue for the morning prayers. Indeed, God is no respecter of persons.
Pastor, what are we going to do?
We?
I mean, what am I going to do?
Evangelist, what is really happening? I expect you to be in Abuja now, where you said God led you to. Is God leading you to leave Abuja again? In any case, this is my sincere counsel. Go before God and make your ways right with him. I'm sorry. I have to join the other brethren to prepare for the morning prayers. I wish you well.
God, Lord, I'm sorry, Lord, I'm truly sorry. Father, forgive me, have mercy on me, Lord, restore me.
Stop me. Stop me. I'm sorry. Ow. Oh. Cast me not away from your presence, O Lord. Take not your Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of my salvation and renew thy spirit within me.
Satan has set a trap to ensnare you. He's waiting patiently for the time when you will walk into the trap, when you will fall into his hands. He's waiting for the time. Oh, he's waiting for the time. You better give no room to him.
Waiting for time, the devil is waiting. Watching, waiting for the time. Don't